Well, you may have heard or seen the bicycles with loud sirens in your neighbourhood. It is happening in Auckland, and young cyclists attach sirens to their bikes and battle each other to prove who's got the loudest sound.
But as I found out, there is a public concern as these young cyclists go to great lengths to get the sirens.
Music is the key to the soul.
The hills are alive with the sound of music.
Turn down for what?
For these guys, the key is to be the loudest.
It's just a battle between speakers, really. Yeah, that's how we fight.
Dupoloto's part of a crew in Auckland's Glen Innes. He says they were inspired by the Sirens on Cars challenge.
So the battles work as loudness, clearness and dryness.
While the youngsters might like it, not everyone digs the tunes. Firstly, they can be loud.
So if your vehicle is excessively noisy, the police can fine you $50. But did you know the same fine could apply to bicycles with loudspeakers?
Then there's the case of the missing sirens from nearby schools.
Early November is when we first began getting these incidences happening in our school.
On the other side of Auckland, Finlayson Park School in Manurewa have had 52 of their sirens stolen.
There were many days when the school had no communication, no intercom systems, no bells, and no fire alarms in the case of emergency. So that's been quite a health and safety risk for our children.
The school has paid out more than $20,000 to replace the sirens, which cost around $300 each.
We've put cages around the speakers and they have been cut off with bolt cutters. We've gone to higher density steel and still that hasn't worked.
So after school, the caretaker has to manually take down some of the sirens and put them back up the next day to prevent them from being stolen.
It's just not fair. This is the money that should be going towards our children and now it's gone to just repair senseless acts.
It's not just schools that have been targeted by the thieves. Even sirens here at the fire station have gone missing.
You've got some speakers here. Were they stolen?
No, that one's bought. We bought this off our mate. He has the receipt.
Local authorities suspect the battling bike riders are responsible for the missing sirens, but as yet can't find evidence.
Talk to the local board, talk to the council, and just see what ways of at least facilitating anything that'll be beneficial to what they want to happen around it.
I think our speakers will. Dupoloto says his crew are not responsible for the thefts, but admits he can't speak for other groups.
To all the boys out there who's stealing sirens, I'd like to say stop. You know, stealing sirens is like stealing a life.
Now, the police are investigating still the missing sirens, so if you have sirens missing from your school or if you know of any other sirens missing, do report it to the police.
I think it's very serious. I mean, if your child is biking around with those sirens, first of all, it looks stupid. That's my opinion anyway. And tell them off. This is kids' lives at risk.
The school's missing the sirens. How would they hear if there's like a fire alarm or something like that?
Well, do stay with us. After the break, the newsreader with the golden voice, Neva Risimano, on life, depression and marathon running.
I was in a very dark place. I was overweight. I was smoking cigarettes, probably over a packet a day. All of a sudden, I hit rock bottom.